गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, दिस इज पी सांबय फ्रॉम ZPHS तीगलवेणी स्कूल असिस्टेंट इन इंग्लिश गूडूर मंडल डिस्ट्रिक्ट महाबूबाबाद. चिल्ड्रेन लेट्स गेट ऑन विद आवर ओन बिजनेस. टुडे आई वुड लाइक टू बिगिन विद एन इंट्रोडक्शन टू आवर टेक्स्ट बुक. सो वॉट इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू टेक्स्ट बुक? यू मे थिंक लाइक दिस, यू नो, बिकॉज यू हैव बीन स्टडीइंग फॉर द लास्ट 4 or 5 years, स्पेशली 9th and 10th स्टूडेंट्स. और टेक्स्ट बुक इज डिस्कोर्स डिपेंडेंट. What is discourse dependent? What is discourse dependent means what? Every lesson, A reading, B reading and C reading deal with a different kind of discourse. That means lesson is based on discourses. So what is a discourse, sir? What is a discourse? You have been writing, already know. But I would like to remind you once again. Discourse is a means of communication. So what is a means of communication? What does it mean? If you want to communicate with anyone, you have to use a means, you have to use a way. For example, if you want to invite your friends to your house, what do? You send a message, you write a letter. If you want to talk to your friends, what do? Generally, conversation takes place. You know, if you want to keep your memories in record, what do? Just you enter them in a diary. That is called a discourse. So diary, letter, conversation, speech, drama, etc., etc. All these are called discourses. Our lessons are based on discourses. That means if you learn a lesson, if you read thoroughly a lesson, you come to know what a discourse is. So my opinion is that you are not expected to learn discourses first. So I think you learn the lesson first and then you should be able to write a discourse. Because every lesson deals with a different kind of discourse. That means the lesson has all the features of a discourse. If you observe that features, you can write a discourse at your own. Anyhow, discourses are divided into two categories, children. They are major discourses and minor discourses. What are the major ones? What are the major ones? Drama, biography, speech, interview, conversation, essay, description, narrative, choreography, etc., etc. What are the minor discourses? Post preparation, message, notice, invitation, diary entry, profile, etc., etc. Okay, children, these are the some. Actually, I have not written all the discourses here because the video is getting lengthy. I have written some because you know already you have been studying them for the last some years. Okay, children, now let us discuss the present lesson. Actually, why I have introduced all these things, you should come to know what a discourse is. Now, I am sure that we have known something about a discourse. Today, we are going to discuss a lesson from 10th class, from it is a one-act play. Later, you come to know what a one-act play is. Okay, children, you have just come to know what a discourse is. And every lesson from 6th to 10th class deals with a different kind of discourse. You have just come to know about them. Okay, let's discuss the never, never nest. This is C reading from Human Relations of 10th class textbook. Okay, children, what is the never never nest? Every lesson deals with a different kind of discourse. But what does this deal with? This is what you should come to know. Okay, the never never nest is written by Cedric Mount. He belongs to America, one of the greatest playwrights. Actually, this is a one act play. So what is one act play? One act play is a drama. Is there any difference between? Yes, a little difference, but now we are not expected to know about them. Now I will tell the salient features of one act play. What are the salient features of one act play? One act play must have a single setting. So what is single setting? What is setting? Setting is a place where the action takes place. For example, if you take a movie, number of settings will be there. One song will be shot in America, one in Hyderabad, one in Andhra, one in Rayalaseema, like that. But this must be played in one single setting. Only one setting should be there. Setting should not be changed. Next, fewer characters. In drama, more characters are there. But in one act play, maximum 4 or 5 characters must be there. The third one is short duration. Drama may be 1 hour or 2 hours like that. But cinema is 3 hours. But this must have only 40 to 45 minutes. Next, thematic. What is thematic? Every action has a theme. Without theme, there is no action. Whatever the movie you take, compulsorily there will be a theme. And all the characters, all the story will be revolving around the theme. For example, if you take Shatamanam Bhavati, Telugu movie, what is the theme of that family relations? Happy days. What is it? Friendship. In the same way, what is the theme of one I play? It must have one. Yes, that will be there later. Later we discuss it. And didactic. That should give a message compulsory. At the end, you must get a message, you must get a moral from the one act to play. These are the salient features: single setting, pure characters, short duration, 45 minutes, thematic, must have a theme, didactic, must give a message. Okay? Okay, children. Now, let us discuss whether this one act to play has all these salient features. Before that, I would like to give you the characters listed. What are the characters that we have here? Characters, the main characters are Jock, Jill, Aunt Jane, Nurse. Here, Jock and Jill are newly married couple. Aunt Jane is their well-wisher. What is the meaning of well-wisher? Well-wisher means a person who is behind you to help you. A person who always encourages you. A person who always thinks about you. A person who is ready to come along with you in your thick and thin. Such a person is called well-wisher. Here, Aunt Jane will be helpful to the couple always. So, she is a well-wisher here. And nurse. What is the meaning of nurse? Nursing itself is serving. Serving means working. Here, nurse means attendant. A person who works in a house. Here, nurse will be working in Jock and Jill's house. These are the characters. And one more character, Dr. Martin will also be there. And this couple has a baby. Later, we come to know what they do. Okay, children, now I would like to give you the summary. Before giving summary, what is the setting of this play? The setting of this play is a villa. What is the meaning of villa? Villa is a cozy house, a comfortable house, very beautiful house built in a garden. The flowers will be there, plants will be there. Among the plants and flowers, a house will be there that looks very beautiful. That is the setting of this one act play. Next, Jock and Jill, newly married couple, already I told you, they are husband and wife. Actually, they get only £6 a week towards their salary, but they are very much interested to lead a luxurious life beyond their limits. And actually, made for each other, Jock and Jill, you know, both are made for each other. They want to lead a luxurious life, but they get a meager income. How is it possible? They get £6 a week, but they want to get a fridge, car, piano, radiogram, sofa, etc., etc. Is it possible? Yes, today it is possible because there is a ready option. What is that? EMI. Actually, the theme of the action is EMI. EMI means what? Buy now, pay later. Equated monthly installments. For example, if the cost of a TV is 1 lakh, just if you pay 10,000, the remaining 90,000 will be paid on equated monthly installments. That means what? You are not forced to pay all the amount today. So, they are very much vigorous. They are very much interested to go on that way. So, they buy what? A fridge, a car, a piano, radiogram, etc., etc. All they buy. But their income is very meager. Just they get £6, but their installments come to almost around £8. How is it possible? Is it possible to? Okay, actually this scheme is very beautiful. You know, that is alluring us. But is it possible to pay? This is the position of Jock and Jill. One day, Jock is at his business, on his duty. Then Jill is alone at home. Then Aunt Jill visits the house. And she sees the cozy house. She sees all the sofa, furniture, everything. And she gets wondered. She gets surprised. She thinks in her mind, what? The couple is very poor comparing to me. They are poorer comparing to me. I am a rich person. Being a rich person, I am not able to buy all these things. But how is it possible to them? How did they buy all these things? Yet she thinks like that. But she doesn't know in the beginning. When they were talking to each other, Jock comes home. Yes, then everything, she comes to know. All the things have been bought on installment basis. But she doesn't like it because she is a ready cash woman. She always buys on full payment. She doesn't like to buy things on installment basis. So immediately she gets up from the sofa and says she doesn't want to sit on the sofa for which they paid for only one leg. Yes, thus she gets perplexed and she wants to leave. Before leaving, she gives a 10-pound check to the couple and asks them to pay at least for one thing to claim. Then before leaving, Job also gets up and he gets ready to drop her at the bus stand in his car. But she doesn't like it. Why? Because they paid for only one tire. She says that she doesn't want to sit in one tired car. So they go on foot to the bus stand. When they went out, immediately G calls the attendant nurse and gives the check to give to the Dr. Martin. Nurse goes to give to Dr. Martin. Yes, Jock is very happy and he wants to pay at least 2 installments for the car. So he comes very hurriedly to the house. And after coming, he comes to know that the check has already been sent to the doctor. Then he gets angry and he scolds Jill. Then Jill starts crying and she says, "What? If you pay the last installment to the doctor, the baby will be ours." This is the most shocking thing in the play. What is that? Even the baby is also on installment basis. The delivery charges are also being paid on installment basis. Thus, this is a stinging satire written by Cedric Mount. Actually, Cedric Mount wants to give a warning to us. What is that? We should enjoy. We should buy on installment basis. But we should not go beyond our limits. Just as long as the blanket supports, you should stretch your legs. If you go beyond that, we have to face some problems. In the way, you should be within the limits of your salary. If you take more things beyond your salary, you have to face some financial problems. These are self-imposed financial problems. So, Aunt Jane, in the form of Aunt Jane, is warning us to be in our limits. Okay, children, now let us discuss whether the play has satisfied all the features here. What is the single setting? Actually, one act play must have a single setting. What is the single setting here? Villa. What is it? Villa is the single setting. What is villa? It's a cozy, comfortable house in a garden. Next, fewer characters, lesser characters should be there. How many characters are there? Just 4 or 5. Jill, Job, Aunt Jen, nurse, and so on like that. Okay, next, what is the short duration? If you enact this on the dais, maximum it takes 10 to 15 minutes, I think. So, shorter duration. This has shorter duration. Next, thematic. Yes, what is the theme of this one act play? EMI. Buy now, pay later. Equated monthly installments. This is the theme. And what is the moral that you are getting from that? Never build a house like this. Never follow Jock and Jill. This is the moral. If you follow Jock and Jill, you should face so many problems in your life. So, by following the advice of the playwright and Aunt Jen, just be in your limits. Okay, children, bye. Let's meet in other video.